channel. Today, I want to talk about how many handbags that do we need at a given point of time. Thank you, Aaron Han, one of my good friends, for this video idea. Yes, I am ready to talk about how many handbags that we really need. Alright, so it's going to be a chatty video. I hope you like it. And if you haven't subscribed, my name is Amy. I launch video every week all about luxury fashion, my lifestyle, and sometimes if I'm in the mood, I will throw in a cooking video. So if this is something you enjoy watching, I would love for you to hit that red subscribe button and ring my bell so you don't miss out any of my future video. So without further ado, I'm ready to talk about this maybe a sensitive topic, and let's start chatting. So since last spring, a pandemic hit, and it took us a little while before we realized that we were in lockdown and there's nowhere we can go to show off our handbags or to use our lovely handbags. However, I did not stop slowing down buying handbags, so I did purchase quite a bit last year. But after a year later, I kind of realized I am in the point that lost interest. I mean, at this point, at least, lost interest of keep buying luxury handbags because all the bags that I purchased last year, I have not really used them, and I have not really use them and get to know them and have a thoughts of, whether the pros and cons on each handbag that I purchased from last year. So this year, even though I got a Hermes Evelyn, and I believe that's a great purchase for the price and for the bag, and but I haven't really used it, believe it or not, but my mom already used it, for the moment she purchased. So I'm gonna have a video with her to show you guys and her thoughts on her Evelyn and maybe what's in her bag, and also showing you guys with the Evelyn with organizer or without, what's the difference. But that will be another video. However, ever since I purchased Evelyn last couple months ago until now, I am getting the point that I don't know what's my next luxury handbag. So that made me think that how many bags do we really need? Do we really want at a given point of time? And this is something that all of a sudden prompting in my head. And I wanna talk to you guys about it, and I would love to hear from you. So just comment below, let me know how many bags do you want and what's on your wish list and what's your next bag? Because for me right now, I do not know, and I don't know what I want to get next, because I feel like, as you can see behind me, I got all the bags that I want already. I have a Chanel classic flap in medium size. I even got my dream bag, my Chanel Coco handle and the Louis Vuitton Capucine, and I still love my YSL clutch bag, that red one over there, and I got two beautiful Lady Dior. So what's my next bag? I mean, I'm not too crazy about the Prada, the nylon handbag, although it's kind of cute. But I've been telling myself, move away from the trendy handbag, because when I get tired of the trendy bag and when I'm ready to sell some of my trendy bags, I usually will take a big loss. And I'm not ready to do that, because after the pandemic, I kind of feel like that. Sometimes, although we keep buying luxury handbags, but if we don't know how to appreciate each bag, we should not continue buying them. So I've been telling myself that by me buying my next bag, at least I want to have some break. For example, I just purchased the Evelyn bag, so I want to kind of, get to know my Evelyn bag, start using them at least for 3 to 6 months, until I use to the point that I know my bag very well. I can give you guys an honest review on the pros and cons on this particular bag before I, buy another bag, because I think that way I will appreciate each of my handbag more. Because to be honest with you guys, My clutch bag, I got it for a few years ago. I use it less than 5 times. And my cabazine, I got it last year. I use it a couple of times. Even my closet flap, okay, I use it less than 7 times. So why? Because I've been keep chasing after a new bag, after a new bag, but I have not really using the bag I currently have. So for example, in the past, I've been buying bags, but before I get to know my bag, I've been chased after the next bag. So I really think I need to stop doing that. And let me know in the comment below if you are doing what I'm doing and you think it's time to change, because I don't think it's healthy this way. And we really need to adjust our spending habit and the way we appreciate our handbag. So for the past few months, I've been using my Neverfull PM. I think this is the petite size, you know, a lot. I mean, seriously, I really use this every time I go out, and I find it very carefree because I got this bag like 11 years ago, and I, you know, just kind of toss around this this bag, and I don't feel no sweat. So I've been using a lot nonstop for my Neverfull. However, do I feel comfortable to use my Chanel Classic Flap or even Capuzine or even my Elma BB, maybe my Elma BB, but not the red one over there, to go out and during this, you know, this period of time? I'm not sure. However, but with the Neverfull, I feel like so carefree to use. So that is why, you know, made me think that, do I still want to get another bag anytime soon? I mean, we are in May, June right now, and another 6 months remaining. So when is the next time I will get my next bag? I really don't know. And I currently do not have any wish list of what handbag I want to get next. However, I've been telling myself that I do want to get some earrings, maybe Chanel earrings, accessories from different fashion house, because to me, I feel like accessories can really, you know, dress up your whole look, not just the handbag, because you spend a lot of money with all the price increases to buy a bag. But you can buy, you know, you can spend a fraction of the money to buy accessory like a scarf, like a pair of earring, like a necklace, and you can still, you know, just kind of dress up your whole look. So that's what I'm gonna do. I've been telling myself I want to be more disciplined on my spending habit, and just kind of start, you know, appreciate my bag. But that doesn't mean I can stop Sarah moving forward buying what she wants. You guys all know she loves handbags and she's gonna keep buying anyway. So, you know, this is my thoughts, and I would love for you guys to share with me your thoughts on how many handbags you think you need in your collection. And at a given point that when you're gonna stop, or you probably want to sell one bag and buy one bag. And that's another way to, you know, not cluttering out your, you know, your collection, because, you know, I don't have the space that I can keep buying, and I don't have the budget of keep buying, not letting things go. So that's why last year I sold quite a bit. Well, yeah, last year I sold quite a few handbags in order to fund some of my new bags. But with all the bags I have, you can see in my bag, I mean, displaying the bag, I love them all, and I don't foresee I would want to sell any of the bags for now. So yeah, so moving forward, I just wanna continue enjoy my bags, but not just going to chase after him back that for that moment, because you know what? Yeah, we have enough. How about you? I feel like I have enough. I feel like I have all the bags that I want, all the styles, all the fashion houses, and I would love to hear from you. And this is just a chatty video, and I hope you enjoyed it. And give this video a like, and we just want to live happy and appreciate our handbags, because we make money really hard, and we just want to spend money wisely on all our luxury bags. Thank you so much for watching, and have a wonderful week. I will see you guys in my next one. Bye-bye.